Hebrews 9:27, familiar scripture. It is appointed unto man once to die. And after death comes judgment. Shortly, I want to share what I titled No Appeal. No appeal. No appeal. No appeal. No appeal. It is appointed unto man once to die. After death comes judgment. There is no appeal. Life seems unfair because of the situations and circumstances that may arise. But death is one of those things that happens in a man's life that seems even more unfair. Life naturally, many people say life not fair. But death again is one of the most unfair situations that anybody may go through. And the reason that death is unfair is because when someone dies, death doesn't give you the ability to say your last words most often. Death is unfair because it doesn't give you time to say goodbye to your loved ones. Many of the treats and tribute that was given to the late Chami, people say, we spoke a week ago, we spoke 2 weeks ago. She cooked for me. She did this. She advised me. But when she was dying, she did not call to say goodbye. That is to tell you that death is unfair. Another thing I want to say about death is that death is a reality. It's real. It is appointed unto man once to die. Meaning that everybody in this world will encounter death. It is not a prophecy of doom. It's a reality of life. The Bible made us to know, Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1, there is a time for everything. And to everything there is a season. A time to born and a time to die. So death is a reality. The third thing I want to say about death is that death is not a respecter of persons. Death doesn't discriminate. Death doesn't know whether you white man or you black man. Whether you rich or you poor. The Bible says Lazarus died and the rich man died also. Also. So the rich and the poor will die. The black and the white will die. The slim and the chubby will die. Educated and illiterate will die. Death is not a respecter of person. There is no discrimination when it comes to death. The 13 or the 15 I want to say about death is that death brings different kinds of reaction. The way you react to death is not the way another person will react to death. Don't judge somebody by their own reaction to death. You know, you only them know what they are feeling at that time. Only them know how to express their grievances and their condolence at that time. In Job chapter 1, verse 20, after they told Job that his 3 children were dead, his sons, 7 sons, and 3 daughters, every one of them were dead. After they told Job that his whole house collapsed, all his businesses, everything went down. The Bible made us to know that in Job chapter 1 verse 20, that the Job lifted up his hands and worshiped the Lord. That was his own way to react to death. But we saw another scripture in John chapter 1 verse 35. Familiar scripture. Everybody know it, even the children. After Lazarus died, the Bible said Jesus wept. This is Jesus we are talking about. Job did not cry. He worshiped. Jesus wept. Why? Death has different kind of reaction. Inasmuch as we came to lay to rest our beloved sister, daughter, mother, and friend. But we that are alive, we should know that this is a sign that every one of us will encounter death one day. And if we are to encounter death one day, I want us to ask ourselves, are we prepared to die? And if we are prepared, where will you spend your eternity? There will be one day where the best food you love will be cooked and you will not be able to eat it. There will be one day that the clothes you have, you want to wear it, you can't wear it because your life is no more. No matter what, there will be one day where people will knock on your door and you can't answer, you can't open the door. Many people that pay the tribute, they call her name, she did not answer. Because there is one day. Everybody will encounter one day. But my point is, when you encounter that one day, after that day, where will you be? Will you be in the bosom of your Father in heaven? Based on your lifestyle? Everything we are pursuing today, marriage, house, academics, money, fame, Every one of us wants to live the best of life. But the truth is that everything you acquire in this world will live right here. There is a French militant by the name of Napoleon Bonaparte. He was a general. He conquered the entire world during the time of his existence. And one day the doctors told Napoleon Bonaparte that you have 2 weeks to live. And Napoleon Bonaparte called his family members, called his friends, and his generals in the army. He said, I have 3 requests before I die. He said, when I die, the first thing I want the whole family to do, that my grave, my casket, should be carried by the doctors. Number two, in the casket, my whole body must be inside, but my palm must be outside. My 2 hands must be outside in the casket. Third thing he requested, he said, when we get to the gravesite, all my gold, all my silver, all my money, all my conquest, everything I conquer, we say around the grave. Don't bury it with me, but we say there before my casket enter the grave. The family and the general, they say, no problem. We listen to you. But why this kind of strange request? He said, number one, I want the doctors to carry my casket so that the world will know that even doctors could not save me. Number two, I want my hands to be outside so that the world will know that they not carry anything with me. Number three, I want all my things I conquer to be outside near my grave before I place in, so everybody will know that everything I labor for, I did not carry it with me. I'm saying this because let's mind how we live our lives. Because of iPhone, because of money, because of this, because of that, many of us put ourselves in all manner of things, pressurize ourselves. But there will be one day that what you did now is what later will do to you. So we should be conscious that this, as much as we came to lay to rest our sister and our daughter, that we that are living should be conscious of what we do. We should be conscious of the life of Christ. That life without Christ is crisis. But life with Christ, your cry will cease. There was a boy.